couple of weeks. But to go into that room and have the managers peel back, and then actually see light coming in, is more than words can really describe. All of a sudden, there's the overwhelming whoosh of visual input. Things resolving colors and shapes, images whooshing everywhere. Leave those eyes allow light to reach Michael's residence. But Michael has a problem. After 40 years in the dark, his brain does not recognize what his eyes have seen. It wasn't as simple as just turning on the light and all of a sudden being able to read a book. It's much more complicated than that. Vision isn't something where you flip a switch. So what visual sense will Michael have of a world he's not seen in 40 years?
Hot signs, tonight from 9 on Discovery Science. Some days still have to be gone, and some sections will become quite back. Children could be gone, fear, and even back in the moon. I know that this is not a good thing. The human life is getting better. Providing extreme conditions. So remember, people can ultimately find a new heaven for the unconscious.
This sense of size, shape and distance, light and shape, isn't that a curve, a step down, a step up, or a shadow? Just in terms of the brain's ability to make a curve, I'm just not able to perceive that information. If he had spent a childhood seeing and playing with his bicycle and riding off curves such as inside it, he would have learned several different cues. The lesson distinguishes between a 3-inch curve at one distance, a 6-inch curve a little further, and a 9-inch curve further than that. But prior to that experience, it gets to be very hard to do so on a possible basis alone. Now, Michael's adult brain also struggles to catch up on the learning it missed as a child. But Michael does recognize and enjoy some things. I'll use a cane to deal with what's in front of me, and then I can look around and appreciate the things that I can perceive. Bright colored flowers, landmarks, people walking by, things like that that I can use my vision for. And I don't even think about what's in front of me.
Michael May inhabits a limbo between blindness and sight. His progress frustrated by his nearly empty library of visual memories. But every day, his library grows.
Our powers of vision illustrate just how intricate and sophisticated our body's design is.
Vision is the sense we rely upon most,
and it's helped make possible the rapid development of our species.
Coupled with advances in medicine and biotechnology, our vision will also be the key to our future. Put together the startlingly efficient design of the human eye, and the power of the brain to interpret and extrapolate information, and visionary advances in optic science. And sooner than we think, there might very well be a lot more out there for us to see.